Sorry about that.
That's from the movie Wittgenstein, and talking about there's no unicorns in this room, and you know, how do I know? Reminds me of that scene from that movie where they're arguing over something basically the same. We could even say seriously we don't worry about unicorns because they're mythical beasts. I know hippogriffs don't exist because they're biologically impossible. You have half a horse, half a bird, right?
So we're all half centaur.
Mermaids.
Yeah, I didn't realize this was going to be such a traumatic class for some.
Yeah, you're making my day really shitty right now.
Let's not get into
truth. Look at me if you're talking about evolutionary biology. I prefer that they exist.
Understood. Well, so ontology is the study of what exists and how it exists. So it's really part of physics too, because if we're talking about there is no matter today. Instead, when we get down to the standard
subcourse particles,
the standard what do we call it? The standard.
I don't know. This works.
You know, various particles and everything. The standard something. The heck is it?
An English major. I can't.
Model. Standard model.
Oh. Overcomplicating something, I guess.
We have the standard model. So these are the things that exist. Everything is made up of those.
Charm.
The top, the bottom, the charm, the strange, the up, the down, quarks. And then we have electrons, muons, the tau. I don't know what all these are.
Yeah, what is this?
I have no idea. What
standard
model. Never heard of this.
Elementary physics.
Being smaller than quark, as basically high and low energy.
Forces, I believe. Sounds like some made up bullshit.
When I saw charm, I thought you were joking. So.
Pardon?
But I guess you're not joking.
Oh, no, so...
I definitely thought this was a joke.
So, yeah. It's the forces of energy that makes up what, you know...
Yeah, these in various arrangements are what make up all of
charm
the particles.
Charm equals 1.275 g v/c^2. Okay.
They have the measurements of what they are, so...
I don't know how to read those measurements, so...
It's not my fault.
incredibly small charges.
But you put those all together and you get bigger and bigger and bigger things. But the thing is, at this level, this isn't matter. This is subatomic. And matter officially occurs at the atomic level. So matter consists of subatomic things which don't, they're not matter.
They don't matter.
Oh, okay.
Unless you get a random prion that's running around in your brain and destroying stuff. That's when you get mad cow disease. You get random prions running around.
Okay. Good talk.
It might take 25 years, but eventually you're going to be crazy and start lying down in the field and not wanting to get up.
You could just eat lead.
Unless you're not in the field, I suppose.
Okay. Moving on.
So ontology. So ontology is the study of what there is. It's not actually an easy science, and there are people that disagree over it. String theory is another aspect of that.
The multiple parallel universes, right? Is that what it was? The whole was that string theory?
The metaverse, yeah.
Okay.
There's more than one universe, which that's just wrong. It's like the word atom. Once they realized they could break atoms down into parts, they should have changed the name, because atom is the Greek for uncuttable, and once you can cut them, Well, then it's not an atom anymore. You should call it something else.
Well, they did.
Well, they
not an atom.
Still call them atoms.
Yes,
yeah.
But the thing that they've broken down is therefore not
the
called an atom.
No, what they took, but the fact that they can break apart an atom means its name is alive. They should change the name.
Right, right. A monad is good, but then monads were meant to be really these. So that was life. But so the ontological argument comes from the definition of God. What is God? So the first part of this concerns the theological definition of God, and I have it. It's from the text, and it is God is that than which, or greater than which, nothing greater can be conceived. Left it up someplace where. So, did you catch that though? God is that than which nothing greater can be conceived. You could also say thought. Of course, we're translating from the Latin. But by the way, this is still the official definition in theological circles, as far as I know. So, by definition, God is that than which nothing greater can be thought. Notice it's in a negative, it's a negative approach, what they call the via negativa. It's via means road, negative way, instead of the via positiva, positive, right? So it's or affirmativa, right? You're looking at saying not so much what God is as what is not. So God is that than which nothing greater can be thought. So, if we say it that way, and I can think of specific things. So, for example, my favorite, pizza. Do pizzas exist?
I sure hope so.
No disagreement over pizzas, right? In fact, I know that there's at least 3 pizzas in my freezer at home. They're DiGiorno.
Can I come over?
Right. So DiGiorno pizzas, right? So I know there are pizzas, and let me ask you, is there in Eagle River at this moment a largest pizza?
Yeah.
Just in Eagle River?
Yeah,
largest
in the world.
There are other pizzas in Eagle River, right? I imagine there's Pizza Man over there. They have large pizzas.
Pizza Hut,
Pizza Hut,
Pizza
the Hut,
large pizza in general.
Which is the largest pizza in the rivers?
Well, at the moment, it might be being eaten as we're speaking.
Yeah.
Yeah, it might not be in this
morning.
Sorry,
oh,
it's
yeah, but at this particular moment,
oh
if there
God,
are pizzas,
it.
Right,
it's delicious.
Doesn't one of the ones that's here might be just by like a micro bit, if we
that's
were
so
to measure them, but wouldn't there have to be a largest pizza in Eagle River?
Yeah.
Yes.
And you don't know that from actually going out and looking.
Well, actually, the two pizzas were the exact same size, but they were both the largest.
But if you weighed them with a really fine measurement device,
exact same.
I'm sure you could probably. Could it? Is it possible for them to be exactly the same?
Yeah.
Theoretically, yes.
Is it likely? No, but.
I kind of sort of want it not to be possible.
Yeah,
why not?
I feel like maybe if you delve really, really deep into physics, it'll be some rule where like
not in two elementary. Two exactly weighing pizzas cannot be in the same universe at once.
Exactly, so just pizza. It only applies to pizza.
The pizza. That would make sense. Pizza the Hut rule.
The pizza.
But okay, how about the smallest pizza? Somewhere
yes.
in Eagle River.
Yeah. Yeah.
You didn't declare it as a pizza anymore. Though.
Be a cracker.
Could the pizza, could the crumb of pizza underneath my desk?
Joking. But you said you were going to make me a pizza.
Exactly.
Here you go.
These are the questions, man.
Okay, well, now let me extrapolate a little bit further and say, how about in all of Alaska, is there a largest pizza?
Yes.
Yes. In all of the U.S.?
Yes.
In all the world, yes. In all the universe,
yes.
Okay. So we've got pizza.
You gotta cover all your bases.
Yeah. I'm just, now what?
But by the definition of God, God is that in which nothing greater can be thought. So do you think the largest pizza in the universe is greater than God?
Yes. You should not be asking.
I did not see that.
You
should not ask.
Just a
bunch
of
college students. Yeah,
we're struggling.
That's
what yeah.
The world,
you're supposed to say no.
Okay.
Because by definition, of course, God is greater
well,
than anything
so
else.
Mm-hmm. So we're talking about weight here?
What if God doesn't exist?
Then that's a false statement.
Then Oh, that's right. But this is the official definition.
But
so
if
it's
God
not that it could be false. That's what everyone who's a theologian basically starts with. The definition. It's not like they're out there looking for God and trying to find is he,
right,
she, or it going to match this, right? That's the definition. Because all the previous definitions were found wanting. They're not good enough. So this is the where this occurs, of course, is in the proslogium and the monologium, both, which if you read, hopefully you were impressed and puzzled, maybe had your head hurt a little bit. Because if that's the case, and there are things that exist, but the definition of God is correct, then God exists. By the way, if you write a paper on this, be careful, because I get a lot of papers that say God exits. So spell exists correctly. Exists, not exits.
God exits.
Exits.
God exited this realm. He's just done with humanity.
So God is that in which nothing greater can be thought. If God does not exist, then I can conceive of things like pizza that are greater than God, but by the definition of God, God is that in which nothing greater can be thought. It can't be the case that other things exist and are greater than God. So therefore, God exists.
What if you don't believe in God? How does that get thrown in?
Well, that's fine. You don't have to believe in God. You just have to agree that the definition is correct.
If you don't agree.
Yeah, exactly.
A lot of people don't agree. That means that they're not edumacated theologians.
Oh, whoops.
Yeah. So you're not part of the discussion.
Sorry.
Gone. You're irrelevant.
Gosh.
Right. Right. But I mean, you know, you could say the same thing happens, you know, I've talked to people, Einstein says E equals MC squared. It's kind of odd. Do you agree? No, I don't believe it. You know what?
Cool.
No physicists care about that person.
Yeah.
That person's not part of physics. String theorists are not going to listen to that person.
So then does it affect you if you aren't in that field?
No.
Does the definition?
No. I mean, you can live a perfectly fine life not knowing anything about theology. That's true.
Cool.
interesting argument that because of the impact religious beliefs have on society, I mean, I don't know the shooter in Florida if he had any religious reason for, I doubt it. But yeah, there are terrorists that have religious reasons for harming other people. So arguably, religious belief can cause damage to other people, to society, cause wars, have done that, right? Even the greatest of the religions have, you know, in fact, you know, all the great churches have existed because they've been successful at war. So that sounds awful. But it seems like they've grown out of it. The main religions have grown out of being violent.
When you're
talking about people like the Pope or the Imam, you know, now it depends. So the argument, and I get this from Miroslav Volf, which I think I showed him the other day, want to create an international consortium of theologians from all the major religions that will all come together and basically form like a constitution of what you have to believe in order to have a religion and profess it. So you have to be licensed to teach other people what you believe as a religion, right? You won't be allowed unless you pass a test. And those people will have to pass the test that says God is that in which nothing greater can be thought.
Well,
basic requirements, right?
Like 100 questions, and you just disagree with that one. So
that's just one of them. That's just one of the ones. But I'm sure what they're also going to say is that killing others for your religion is not an indication that your religious beliefs are coherent. So no, you can't believe that. You can't go out and teach other people that you ought to kill so-and-so because of their beliefs. That will not be allowed. You won't be given a license. And if you don't have a license, you won't be able to start, you know, build a church in Wasilla and say, aha, I'm going to start my own first or second church. Second church of Christ's witnesses. Or whatever you want to call it. The third church.
There's a reason why it's
maybe the fourth church of Christ, Jehovah's Witnesses or something. Yes?
So, with that definition, is it acceptable to say gods with like in parentheses?
No.
No? Oh my god. Okay, but then it's not including other religions. So then with your little test thing.
Oh, well, they don't rate if they have gods plural. Math has demonstrated they were wrong. This actually seems to have first developed thanks to Egypt and their mathematics. The very first monotheist, as far as we know, was Akhenaten. Yes, Akhenaten. Who tried to destroy polytheistic religions and create a monotheistic religion in Egypt. And
so then why is that
I've
wrong?
Seen pictures of him and he's dead.
Yeah.
I would assume he's dead.
Didn't work out well
now.
For him.
No. Did I show you my pictures from
No, I don't think so. I don't know where, but
she just wants to see pictures.
Yeah. Well, we've got this marvelous device.
Did you make this video?
Yes. but I'm not sure I'm in the right room.
Okay.
That's his wife, Nefertiti, I believe. This is in the University of Pennsylvania Museum of Art and Archaeology. If you ever get there, you can go. Notice the rays coming down from the divine, from the sun.
They got some cool stuff in the Louvre, too.
That's, I guess, King Tut right there, the baby. Because when they killed Akhenaten, they made his son, King Tutankhamun. Am I in the right? I'm in the right room. These are all my videos, so that's the Alaska State Fair. But yeah, so there's all kinds of
baboons
were like highly respected by the. There's a joke book of Egyptian ancient comedy where they have everybody all rowing in the boat, and the baboon is the one calling, you know, the
kings.
The cadence, and that's considered to be a joke because, you know, they're making fun of the guy who's the leader. It could be metaphorically Trump, you know, that's the one that's calling it, you know. You think about it. So, what's wrong with this art? How many of you are not convinced?
I want it.
That God exists, because
no,
just by the definition alone, God must exist. Yes.
Definitely not convinced.
Not convinced. Okay,
oh,
so the question is now, why isn't it convincing to you? There's like two possibilities. One, you find something wrong with the argument, or the other one, just like the poor guy that doesn't understand E equals MC squared, right? Mm-hmm. You get it, right? And Aquinas in the Summae, let me see if I can find that, talks about individuals that so, for a theologian who knows the definition that God is that than which nothing greater can be thought, God existing is self-evident. Now, those things are said to be self-evident to us, the knowledge of which is naturally implanted in us, as we can see in regard to the first principles. But the knowledge of God is naturally implanted in all. Well, but no, it isn't, right? So that seems wrong. But notice this is also an objection. And what the Summa is a list of objections and the answers, and then what Aquinas says in order to resolve the dispute. Sic et non, actually, is what they called it. Yes and no. It's kind of like a particular kind of scholastic dispute method, right? So those things are said to be self-evident, which are known as soon as the terms are known. So the when they say the philosopher, they're talking about Aristotle. set of first principles of demonstration. First principles, by the way, are a thing is what it is, and not another thing, right? The second one is a thing cannot both be and not be at the same time. So you are either here or you're not. It can't be the case that you are both here and not here.
Oh, but it can.
Halfway inside the doorway.
Not even that. Okay.
Well, you are.
You're
in the
like,
you're in transition.
You're
in transition.
Good effort. But no, I'm going to try something. So let's say you have your Oculus Rift on. Your body is in Alaska, but your mind is elsewhere. You're in, like, the loop. Okay,
you know
so.
Me well enough now to know that my mind is elsewhere.
Exactly.
Yeah,
okay, I'm
you
sorry.
You don't need Oculus Rift out of your mind.
Well, yeah, you can be in a place and be totally somewhere else.
Well, you're somewhere else, too.
Of course.
Because at the moment, how fast is the Earth going?
Okay. Really?
So, you know, we're spinning. You know, the reason you're sitting in that chair is because you happen to be moving in a trajectory that enables you to just push into that chair as it's moving. Well, sorry, which model is that that I'm using?
It's I don't know. One of them.
Has anybody solved gravity yet? I don't think so.
Solve gravity? What's there to solve?
What's there to solve?
The world's flat.
The world's flat is going up.
If you walk
well,
far enough that
speaking,
way, you'll fall.
Gravity
off.
Is Sir Isaac Newton's conception of gravity, and he's been proven wrong. It doesn't work.
It's just a curve.
Yes. Curved space, yeah. So, my mind is elsewhere, but so is yours.
Mm-hmm.
We're not really sure about time and space.
This is true.
Isn't this fun? Isn't philosophy? Why would anybody not
annoying.
Want to be a philosophy major?
Because
it's
they like
fun,
knowing
the
where
day,
they stand.
Like,
they like having
circles.
A solid position in life.
Yeah. Yeah,
exactly. Well, here you go. Here's the start of that. By definition,
oh my God.
God is that in which nothing greater can be thought.
Well, then, how does God exist if we don't exist? That's what I want to know. Okay, because if we're not
exist.
Here to listen to this definition, then who is? And then, how does God exist?
We don't have to be here for E equals MC squared to be true.
This is true.
And this is the same kind of thing by definition.
I think you're caught up on the concept that God is a creator and not God is that than which nothing greater can be thought.
Yeah, God doesn't have to be
God
a
doesn't
intelligent
have to be a hairy
being.
Old man who's, you know, creating stuff. God is just the greatest thing that can ever be thought.
It just depends if you have to discover something for it to actually
are we talking about like the idea behind God or
we,
at, like the actual
God? Itself,
God?
We're not
like
well,
pizza itself,
a weakness
like
of this argument
God
is that this doesn't prove any other characteristics. So it doesn't prove that your particular conception of God is what God is, or that God like is Jesus, or the Christian God, or the Islamic God, or you know, the sun god, or any of those things, right? Doesn't prove anything except that by definition, something that is that than which nothing greater can be thought must exist, or else something else is greater, but that can't be the case because of the definition. So therefore, that than which nothing greater can be thought must exist. By definition. But because we're calling it God makes a lot of people upset over it.
So wait, would this be God is above whatever thing we could think of? Or
that's
would God be equal to the highest thing we
if,
think of?
If I try to get more specific,
that sounds like a fire box.
Yeah, they've been screaming ever since I walked in.
Nicely.
Yeah, like they're having a good time, kind of screaming, not like I'm being tortured. Please save me, screaming.
So the most recent, actually, I'm sure there's more recent versions of this ontological argument too, but one of the more famous contemporary ones is Kurt Gödel's argument. The trouble with it is it's in
smart Germans out there.
It looks like this. So that doesn't help.
No,
it really doesn't.
But if Kurt Gödel, who was like a genius, except he couldn't eat, was afraid of his food.
Yeah.
So he starved to death.
Why,
like all geniuses.
Why was he afraid of his food?
He thought the Nazis were trying to poison him.
I'd
they were trying to poison. His wife were moved to Princeton, New Jersey, where he went to the Math Institute, which was invented just for him and for Alfred Einstein, and the two of them would walk to the Institute each day and then back. Actually caused an accident as a car driver was driving by and saw them walking there and was distracted and ran into a tree.
Was the driver okay?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Did he know who he was seeing or what they weren't?
Well, that's what happened. He was driving along and he said, Einstein! And
I didn't know he was that famous at that point.
They had a ticker tape parade and everything for him. And
he decided to join the winning team.
This is proof. It works. At least according to Gödel. And Gödel.
Yeah, but well, that proof we don't understand. Well, I mean,
who would want to argue with Gödel?
Did he just make up these symbols? Or?
Yeah,
really?
Yes, they did, actually.
I'm going to put this diamond and this square with
a
letter
sure. I
and a U bend.
Like something else I didn't know about.
No,
and it
nope,
exists.
That was the original wing game right there.
I've never figured it out myself. Although I've in logic I can usually come up with symbols to represent the argument.
Just so we can display ideas in a mathematical format because the numbers don't lie.
Well, but the weakness.
That formula is what I was getting at.
The weakness is that it's essentially proved nothing. Because by definition, that than which nothing greater can be thought must exist. Well, duh. Of course it does. But then what? You know, so all the things that people really want, like, so now you better convert or die, or now you better believe or you're going to hell, or, you know, you should tithe or else. None of that follows.
Yeah.
None of that follows. So basically, doesn't prove anything. And Immanuel Kant famously argued that existence itself is not a predicate. In other words, you're giving me an incomplete sentence. At the very end of your so-called proof, you're saying, therefore, God is, and you don't complete the sentence. But Hegel thought that's nonsense. This exists. So you see that works. You know.
I thought they all created each other on the screen.
So this is really, you can see why this is one of the funnest arguments that ever existed.
In fact,
I might even say that this is that than which. This is the argument than which nothing. No greater argument. But we can have other fun with this too because let me replace this concept.
Oh, put pizza there.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Get rid of the pizza.
Come on now. You said more fun, so I.
Let's get rid of. Let's leave that.
gray?
And
it's gris.
It's Spanish for gray.
It's greener.
Gris.
There are green things?
What? Oh, green here.
Green is that which nothing compared to be thought. Think.
We have green things.
Ruby rod.
Trees.
Pine.
Trees.
The only green thing
there's kinds of green.
Green
beans.
Probably. Isn't there great art that's just like a green square or something?
Probably.
Well, I was
going
to go back to
probably
the reason why in art, theological art, there are certain shapes and colors that show up repeatedly.
Look at that.
It's the symbolism of a dollar.
There you go.
That's a very large one.
Millions of dollars worth of art.
Especially if it was, you know.
I've been in museums where I've seen, like, you know, an 8-foot by 8-foot orange.
Get it,
I forget who's the artist that like just like flings paint at a
half of
forget
a lot, half of them.
No, I forget, but there was
I have to be careful because my son does that. So
oh,
when I'm recording it. So except Bill. Bill is a great artist.
He makes some of it looks cool.
He makes weird things that really are intriguing though.
Wait,
see if I can.
For a second I thought your profile picture had
that's
Darth
the
Vader
universe.
In.
That's the universe.
Yeah? Oh no, I was gonna say the actual profile picture had Darth Vader in it. You're standing with Darth Vader.
See this thing here, which is I think wood or rock, and he put cut aluminum to match it in the middle.
So
and this
Bill.
Bill.
Yeah, that says Bill.
Yes, it does.
he's got other friends that do things too, but
I envy him having friends.
Where's his thesis, though? Yeah, so he made this? No, that's a dog.
That would be really weird if he made
that. Shoot, this is not working out. Oh, well, that was his studio down in Arizona after he emptied it because he graduated.
That's awesome.
Oh, this is his wife's work, Emily.
Doing relief cutting of.
So he made those. So those are cups. He made those cups. But I wanted to talk about the greenest thing. There are green things.
That's pretty cool.
Okay.
What is the greenest?
Is there the same thing with pizza, right? Is there a largest pizza? There has to be a greenest thing.
I mean, you can only be so green. Like,
well, we'd have to come up with the criteria for how we can measure it.
Right. Like, you could always use the scientific model. Say,
don't
this particular thing.
How about instead of the greenest, we have the ugliest.
That's mean.
Oh.
You want to fight me over this?
Oh.
All yours, homie.
Okay. Oh, it's not ugliest.
Have a con-
it's uglier?
Well, it's the thing that...
That's in which nothing uglier
okay.
can
okay.
be thought.
It
okay,
has to
it.
Be the proper qualifier to make the sentence structure legit.
Smallest?
Smaller.
I mean,
smaller.
Think of it. You know, any...
Well, there's a term for
smaller.
It, I don't know, right?
Evilest.
Well,
evil.
I think it would be most evil.
Worse.
There you go.
Worse.
Yeah, worse.
Worse. Nothing worse.
Worstest.
Worcestershire. Gotta get that tamarind.
Worcestershire.
Nothing worse can be false.
Stepping on the way
that, up. That must exist too, right?
Others.
There are worse. worse things than philosophy class?
There are.
Sitting in traffic when you have to pee.
Okay, yeah.
No, but you could qualify that as like an ELE, an extinction level event. You know, where nothing would be worse than us as a species being removed from existence.
This ontological proof actually works for all sorts of things, including God.
Uh-oh, logic.
So that teaches us something about the way our own language works, the logic. But in a sense, it's kind of like the number system. If we have 1, 2, 3, 4, what comes after 4?
I think it's 5.
5, 6.
Yeah.
And the highest number.
9.
Is always a higher number.
10.
Which if you do like this, it looks like you count like that.
Really?
Sure.
Does it really?
Yeah.
Right now it looks like a triangle.
But so this is the highest number. Nothing can go
but
higher.
But it's
than
not
that.
Because there are sizes of infinity.
Not in
there are.
Yeah. For example, the infinity between 0 and 1. The infinity between 0 and
seriously, you should look
anything.
Up the
And then you can square all those values and that's a bigger infinity.
The infinite hotel is if you really want your brain to hurt, Google it.
Hour.
See what happens.
Well, there's a neat book by David Foster Wallace.